Hare Krishna. According to the verdict of Shastras, a person has to be recognized or identified by his symptoms. And our founder Acharya, Sri A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, in his Bhagavad Gita as it is, verse number 2.54, he says that in this world, every man or every person has to be recognized by his symptoms. And he gives the beautiful examples, such as if a person says, I am a rich man, then he has to be recognized by the symptoms of richness. If someone says, I am a poor man, then he has to be recognized by his symptoms. If someone says, I am a very intelligent man, then he has to be identified by the symptoms. If a person says, I am a healthy man, so there should be some symptom of a healthy person. If someone says, I am a patient, or I'm not healthy, there must be symptoms. So the point is, in this world, everyone has to be recognized or identified by the symptoms. So if I say myself that I'm a devotee of Krishna, so I have to be recognized by the symptoms, not simply by wearing this cloth, saffron cloth, or putting a tilak, putting a kanti mala, I can call myself as a devotee. Simply by appearance look, one cannot be called as a devotee. But to devotee, one has to have the symptoms of devotion, and there are many symptoms in the scriptures in Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita that talks about a symptom of a devotee. Like one of the symptoms in Srimad Bhagavatam, it is mentioned that triskrita viripta labda shipta shapta hata hapi napati kurvanti tad bhakta prabhavo api. A devotee of the Lord is so forbearance. According to Vedic verdict of Shastras, a person has to be identified by the symptoms. And our founder Acharya, Sri Srimad A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, in his Bhagavad Gita as it is, verse number 2.54, he says that every person in this world has to be recognized by the symptoms. And he gives the beautiful examples in his purport. He says that if person is rich, then he has to be recognized by his symptoms. If person is poor, then he must have some symptoms. If person is healthy, there must be some symptoms. If somebody says, I'm a very poor man, he must have some symptoms. So the point is, in this world, everybody to be recognized or identified the symptom that he has. So if I myself call as a devotee, then I must have a symptoms of devotee. Without the symptom of devotee, I can't call myself as a devotee of Krishna. Simply by wearing a saffron cloth or simply by wearing a devotional cloth and putting a tilak, putting a kanti mala, I can't call myself as a devotee. To have a devotee, I must have a symptoms. And what are those symptoms? It is mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam. There is a verse, Triskrita viripta labdha shipta chapta hata hapi nasya tat prati kurvanti tad bhakta prabhavo api. It is mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam that a devotee of the Lord are so forbearance, then even if he being defamed, being cheated, being cursed, being neglected, even being killed, he never ever retaliate with the wrongdoer. He never ever contract with the wrongdoer. This is the quality of a devotee. One of the symptoms is an amazing tolerance. And in our Krishna book, that is also written by our founder Acharya, Srimad A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, in chapter number 89, entitled The Supreme Power of Krishna, there Prabhupada mentions that one's greatness has to be estimated by ability to tolerate provoking situations. Just see, who is a great man? Not that one who has a lot of money, who has a beautiful wife, who has a big bungalow. Generally, if you see, people have this material conception of greatness. He must have some power, some post, some where he can influence the people, he can control the people, he have a lot of money or name, fame, glory, such things. But here, Prabhupada is not saying that. He's saying, one's greatness has to be estimated. Just see the specific word of Prabhupada. One's greatness has to be estimated by ability to tolerate provoking situations. There is a pastime of Bhragumuni where the sages assembled in the Naimisharanya and they wanted to know who is the, there are three God who control the universe, Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, Lord Vishnu. So they want to know the who is greatest. So in that connection, they were meeting and they appointed Bhragumuni to search for it, who is the greatest. Then there is a little long story how Bhragumuni goes and tested everyone. But the conclusion is the Lord, he provoked Lord Brahma by saying something mental, provoke Lord Vishnu by physical offense. But Brahmaji retaliated, Shivji retaliated, but Vishnu was not retaliated. He was too humble and he expressed amazing humility. He was not provoked by the provoking situations given by the Bhragumuni. So therefore, Prabhupada writes, one's greatness has to be estimated by ability to tolerate provoking situations. और वहाँ पर प्रभुपाद जी बहुत सुंदर एक उदाहरण भी देते हैं, एक सूरज, एक दीपक और हवा का, कि जब तेज़ हवा चलती है तो दीपक बुझ जाता है, लेकिन जब खूब आंधी चल रही है, तूफान है, चक्रवात चल रहा है वायुमंडल में, लेकिन सूरज का कोई प्रभाव नहीं पड़ता है. तो दिस इज़ द क्वालिटी ऑफ ए वैष्णवा और ए डिवोटी ऑफ कृष्णा, दिस इज़ वेरी टॉलरेटिव. डजंट ही इज़ धीरा, प्रभुपाद से धीरा मीन्स वन हु इज नेवर डिस्टर्ब इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ डिस्टर्बेंस, ही इज़ ए धीरा. सो दीज आर द सिम्टम ऑफ ए डिवोटी. Simply having a knowledge of scriptures and adopting knowledge, inquiring knowledge is not wrong, is good, is appreciated, it must be welcome. But this knowledge has to be manifested through our action, our behavior, our character. Then it is the success of getting the knowledge. So if I think that on my own mundane intellect I'll get the knowledge, I'll become a devotee, that's not a proper mood, that's not a devotional attitude of a devotee. So having knowledge is very good. But how we are applying that knowledge in our routine life, that is all important. Otherwise, if we have all knowledge, and when the testing situations comes, when the provoking situations come, when the calamities comes, then how do I behave? Then how do I react? That is what counts. So knowledge means it has to be reflect with our devotional qualities, with our devotional character. Otherwise, it is very good to memorize the verses, learn the philosophy of Krishna consciousness, but when you are not able to apply, when the testing situations come, then it's not so successful. Then we are missing something substantial, we are missing. So the point is, having knowledge is very good of scriptures, but simply by knowledge, I myself cannot become a devotee unless until I reflect those knowledge through my action and through my character. So devotee means one who is a symptom of devotional qualities. That is called a devotee. Devotee means one who has a devotional qualities. So our knowledge has to be manifest through our action. Then it is perfect. So our devotional strength can be checked in a provoking situations, in a testing situations. How much you have become a devotee by adopting the philosophy of Krishna consciousness, it has to be checked in a testing situation, in a provoking situation. Then we can say ourselves that I am a devotee of the Lord. Foolishly, I think I may become a devotee of the Lord. So one strength of devotion can only be checked in a provoking situations. So focus is application. Having knowledge is good, is very good. But how I'm applying this knowledge in my routine life, in my day-to-day routine life, that has to be checked. So application is very essential part of a devotee. Our, as far as speaking concern, even a Kansa, even a Ravana, even a Hiranyakashipu spoke such a profound philosophy. They were the great knower of Vedas, great knower of philosophy of Krishna consciousness. They spoke beautiful philosophy of bodily concept of life. And their philosophy was exactly according to the our Acharya of Goli Madhya Sampradaya. But they were not able to transform heart of anyone because they missed the point. They were just having a knowledge, but they are fail to apply in their own life, in their personal life. They were speaking philosophy, but they were not able to accept the concept that one has to become a humble servant of Guru and Krishna. Gopi Bhartu Padakamlayo Das Das Dasanu Das. Therefore, they were not, no one has taken their words seriously, their philosophy seriously, and they were not able to transform of everyone. So speaking philosophy is one thing, but living philosophy is a different thing. That is where the challenge. Prabhupada himself said, the philosophy is easy, but the application is difficult. He said this in first canto. The point is, simply philosophy, speaking philosophy is good, is welcome, but it's just not sufficient. It has to be applied in one's own heart. It has to be imbibed in one's own heart, and then it has to be reflect through our action. So many of the symptoms of a devotee are mentioned in Bhagavad Gita, 13th chapter. Lord himself says the symptom of a devotee or the quality of devotee. He says, Amanitvam adambitvam ahinsa chartim arjivam achar upasanam shaucham istiram apna vinigraha. Then Bhagavad Gita, 13th chapter, Lord Krishna himself speaks about the quality of a Vaishnava, and he says, Amanitvam is humility, adambitvam is pridelessness, ahinsa means non-violence, chantir means tolerance, arjavam means simplicity, achar upasana means approaching a bona fide spiritual master, shaucha means cleanliness, and istra means steadiness, and apnavinigraha means self-control. So these are the symptoms of a devotee. These are the qualities of a Vaishnava, who himself, if somebody wants to consider himself as a Vaishnava or as a devotee of Krishna, then he must have this qualities. Lord Krishna says that knowledge means these are the qualities. So according to Lord Krishna, this is the knowledge. And he clearly says, apart from whatever is there, is all ignorance. Clearly says this. So this is the knowledge. In Srimad Bhagavatam, 3rd canto, 25th chapter, verse number 21, it is mentioned, Titikshva karunika suhrdarp sarvadehinam ajakshatrava shanta sadva sadhu bhushanam. The symptom of a devotee of Lord Shri Krishna, that he is tolerant, merciful, friendly to all living entities. He has no envy, peaceful, abide by the scriptures, and all his characteristics are sublime. So these are the symptoms of a devotee. These are the ornament of a devotee of the Lord Shri Krishna, or of a person who himself want to consider himself as that, want to consider himself as a devotee. जो ये चाहता है कि मैं भक्त बनूँ, कृष्णा का भक्त बनूँ, तो कृष्णा के भक्त बनने के लिए ये सभी गुण होना उसमें आवश्यक है. ये सभी गुण होना जरूरी है, तभी वो व्यक्ति जो है अपने आप को कृष्ण भक्त कह सकता है. एंड व्हाट आई सेड हियर, इट इज़ नॉट फॉर एनी वन एवरी वन, इट इज़ स्पेसिफिकली, मोर स्पेसिफिकली ओनली फॉर मी. It is not for anyone else in the world. In other words, it's me who is speaking, and is the me who is hearing. So what I said, it is for me. So I seek your blessings, your prayers, your mercy, that shower me your blessings, that what I said, I'll be able to apply in my person's own life, and try to render some service in the mission of Srila Prabhupada. That is what I want actually. And how this, I now at the end I conclude, how this quality will come, this is also mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, chapter number 18. Yasyar bhaktir bhagvati akinchana sarver guna tatra samasate sura harav bhaktasya kuto mahat guna manorathe na dhavato bahin. Simply by performing devotional service to Lord Shri Krishna, one can get all these qualities. So one has to doesn't work separately for each and every individual quality, these are mentioned now. No, one has to simply submit to the words of Guru and Krishna, and by their mercy, this quality will follow him. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much.